The Law of Correspondence. This is the third video in a series explaining the 12 universal laws for beginners. If you haven't seen the first two, make sure to watch them for a better understanding. There are several universal laws, and I'm sure you've heard of certain ones like the Law of Attraction and the Law of Vibration, but have you heard of the Law of Correspondence? It's quite possible that you haven't, and it may be the most important one of all. As you've guessed, it has to do with correspondence or communication. However, it isn't about our communication with one another, but about our communication with different parts of ourselves. Most of the information you will hear or read about the Law of Correspondence addresses the unique relationship between the inner self and the outer self, one being a reflection of the other. However, I'd like to take it one step further and suggest that there is a third essential component to consider when understanding how this law works, and that is the relationship with the higher self. No doubt you're aware of the expressions, as above, so below, or on earth as it is in heaven. Well, these ideas pertain to the line of communication or correspondence between the lower energies of the physical mind, earth, and the higher energies of the divine mind, heaven. The key to changing your physical reality is by realizing that you are more of a spiritual being than a physical one. Every step you take in your physical life reflects the spiritual self that is trying to be realized, which is why lessons are repeated in our lives over and over again until we learn them. When the transference of energy from our minds in the form of thoughts, emotions, actions, and words does not reflect a higher wisdom, this lower vibrational energy is, in essence, rejected and returned to us to revisit the same frequency until there is a match. This is why you can be overwhelmed with an emotion or situation you are dealing with. Instead of calling upon your higher self to assist in a resolution, your lower energies are being sent out and returned back to you saying, "Try again." This is a constant motion that occurs in each situation of our lives. The Law of Correspondence teaches us to acknowledge and look at an issue until it is healed. When one's ability to move through a challenge gets closer and closer to being aligned with divine wisdom, by coming from a perspective of peace and love, then those negative, difficult types of situations will stop recurring in one's reality. This is when real change can occur. So, how does understanding the Law of Correspondence shift our perception of the events that happen on a physical level? And how do we stay emotionally stable and wise in the midst of chaos? Let's investigate three ways in which we can make a conscious effort to align with the higher self and receive its guidance at times when the lower, physical self is presented with unpleasant circumstances. Number 1, the mirror image. When you find yourself having a negative experience, recognize that somewhere there is disharmony in your inner world, and your outer world is reflecting that back to you. In other words, your mirror image is not of the true self, it is of the damaged self. You are being shown the changes that need to be made, and the places in your subconscious that need to be healed. When a negative emotion is triggered, it is important to take the time to understand why you are feeling a particular way and how you are reacting to it. Are you relating to your higher self or to your physical self? This is an important consideration because when you access your divine mind, the higher part of your existence, then you allow that mirror of your I Am presence, which is who you truly are, to be revealed within your physical body. So when you take time to change the negative inner thoughts and feelings into positive affirmations, that is when you are truly aligning with your inner truth. It is a moment in time in which you allow the true spirit of you to become the physical you. Number 2, the opposing force. Once you discover the lower frequencies happening in your outer world, you can transform them by applying the opposite energy. Since our energy is reflected back to us at all times, know that when you are faced with something negative, the quickest way to dissipate that energy, heal your subconscious, and connect to your higher self is to react in the opposite fashion. When you are criticized, praise someone. When you are hurt, love someone. When you are discouraged, encourage someone. When you are afraid, reassure someone. In that moment, you're mastering the ability to heal a wounded part of you. You react from your soul's perspective, and thus, you recognize that we are one. Feed the energy that you desire, focus on good and positive thoughts, and the opportunity for healing is created. Number 3, the flow of life. Imagine yourself floating on a raft along a lazy river, completely letting go and trusting in your safety. Each moment flows beautifully into the next. There isn't a doubt or thought that something isn't right. To live one's life in peace and serenity is to live in harmony within the law of correspondence. However, when you encounter rough seas and are being tossed about, that is the wake-up call that your rocky outer world requires some fine-tuning by your inner world. The only lasting change that can take place is from within, then it will show up on the outside. Real change only comes from the higher mind, as above, into the lower mind, so below. Many think that changing the outside temporarily will result in a new, happier life, but they soon find out, hopefully, that the only permanent change comes from the inner self, which should accept guidance from the higher self. Try to flow with life as it happens, and when you feel a jolt, stop and ask yourself where the line of communication between your divine self and your physical self has broken down. More than likely, you will immediately see the discrepancy and be better prepared and aligned next time. It has become more and more important for each of us to be responsible for our own personal evolution and growth so that the world can be heaven on earth. But until that time, the fundamental challenge is being honest with yourself and realizing the potential you hold to create change on the inside and all around. To learn more, check out other videos on this channel. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.